Hi everybody, I am back with the third video in this haul series, and this time this particular video is going to be from the Dollar Tree. And I did finish making my tea, it didn't whistle in the last video, but it's really good. It's just plain Lipton black tea, but I did add honey, I added some cream, and a cinnamon stick, so it's very, very sweet and spicy at the same time, and oh so yummy. So, let's just get into this Dollar Tree haul. I bought some food stuff, and I bought some gifty stuff, and just a bunch of random things. So, so let's just get into it. As far as the food stuff, let me tell you, the Dollar Tree has excellent prices. Everything's a dollar. You already know that. So, if you can find something at the Dollar Tree that you know is at the grocery store, and it's only a dollar, why wouldn't you want to buy it at the Dollar Tree? Because you can try it, and if you don't like it, you really didn't waste any money. So, with that being said, I've never tried this brand, but I do like seasoned breadcrumbs, and this is a huge, huge jar of seasoned breadcrumbs. I just ran out of my breadcrumbs, and I can tell you that a bottle like this or a jar like this is probably about $5 in a grocery store. So I got it for a dollar, and I'm excited about that because that's an awesome price. And okay, well, the battery just died, so I had to reload the batteries and pick up where we left off. So I was just talking about the breadcrumbs. And right before we cut off, I was about to say, who wouldn't want to save money, right? So, also, at the Dollar Tree, I found this. This is probably a larger can than a regular soup can of cream of mushroom soup. And I like to buy cream of mushroom soup because I use it a lot in my cooking when I'm making a cream sauce. It's just, it kind of has everything in it that I already need. And I just add a few other ingredients and I'm good to go, and it makes for a quick cream sauce. Also, food stuff. I've talked about this before. This is the West Soy plain low-fat soy milk drink. And I feel like I have something in my teeth. Excuse me. Sorry about that. But this milk is amazing. It's soy milk, and it's only a dollar for the quart. And it's really, really good, delicious, and very healthy. So it's worth giving it a try if you haven't tried it already. And I've talked about this also before. And this is the Dollar Tree coffee. And they have a lot of different brands. They have, or blends. They have the breakfast blend, they have a hazelnut blend, and they have a French vanilla blend. This time, I just bought the breakfast blend. And it's roasted ground coffee. It makes 50 cups. Weirdly though, this is strange. Wow. They must have had a couple different sizes. Oh well, and I didn't notice that because I picked up a total of 4, and 2 of them are good for 50 cups and 2 of them are good for 40 cups. So, be on the lookout for that. Since they do make a 50 cup package, you want to save more money, get the one for 50 cups. But this is what the package looks like, and they all look the same. It's just that one is a little bit larger, and it was just really hard to tell. Anyhow, it's 6 ounces of coffee in the 40-ounce package and 7 ounces in the 50-cup package. And so, as I said, I bought 4 of those, and I just add them to my coffee can that I keep. And you know what, I don't think I ever showed you my coffee can, so let me grab it real quick, and I'll show you what I do. I just pulled this out of my cupboard. This was, at one time, a coffee can from regular coffee that you buy at the grocery store. And I had some old wallpaper, and so I just covered the can by gluing it around, and then I kept the lid, of course. And then I took a little decorative sticker, and I wrote the word coffee on there and glued it to the can, and just keep my coffee right inside there. So, it smells so good. So I will go ahead and add that coffee to this can, and I'll be good to go. Lastly, for the food stuff, I bought snack pack pudding, and look at my hair there. This, I bought the chocolate, chocolate fudge for Jimmy. He really likes snack pack. They have a generic brand too, but when you see the snack pack in addition to the generic brand, and they're both a dollar, you know, who wouldn't want to buy the brand name, right? So I did that. Okay, now this is just random stuff and some gifty things, and I picked up this. I thought this was really cute. It's a welcome sign in the shape of a three-leaf clover, and it is for St. Patrick's Day. So it's not a four-leaf clover, but it's still lucky and still beautiful for St. Patrick's Day. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use some Mod Podge to seal it, and then I'll be able to attach it to a wreath that I'm going to make for the door for March. So I got that. And I also picked up, this is a starter mix, start seeds indoors, root cuttings, and grow bulbs. It's just a little starter mix of like a peat moss type of blend for my plants that I'm going to start indoors. I have a bunch of different plants, and I think I'm going to share with you in another haul something that I got at the Goodwill store. It's outside right now, but I'm going to have to bring it in just to share with you. And I'm going to make an herb garden. And I think when I start my plants inside, I've saved some cardboard egg crates. And I'll be working with that in that starter mix. So that'll be good for that. Okay, then I got this colored pastel 30 sheets of gift tissue. And I'm planning on using this for Easter in the Easter baskets that I'm creating. Speaking of Easter baskets, I shared with you in a previous video of some of the things that I got for my granddaughter Summer for her basket, and this is something else that I'm going to be putting into it. It is the Hello Kitty cotton candy package, and it says no cholesterol, fat-free, and gluten-free food. It's so cute. I love this little package. And for some reason, I know this is really weird, but I love the sound of these kind of packages. I just think it's so cute. And it's, I don't know, I just like the sound. So I got that for her, and I'm going to add that and include that into her Easter basket. And in the next video, you will get to see the most darling little Easter basket that I found at the Goodwill store for my grandbaby Summer. All right, I bought a couple lotions, body lotions, and this is a new one for me. Actually, both of these that I picked up are new for me, but I did buy the Sweet Seduction brand before in the Wild Rose. This particular time, I got Wild Orchid, and I love packaging. It's a cream color package with the vintage, almost like a vintage wallpaper in black at the top, and then the stripe at the bottom. It's so elegant looking. I really love it. So probably what I'm going to do is, I've been using the rose for a little while, and I do have a backup. You all know that I love to keep backups. If you've been watching my videos, you know that I like to have that in case I run out. So I do have a backup of rose that's brand new, but I think I'm going to take the one that I've been using, throw that in my handbag, since I still am needing to moisturize, since it's been very, very cold out and dry. And then I will take the Wild Orchid and replace the one that I have in the bathroom now that's rose, instead of putting the brand new rose one, I will put, did I just confuse you? I will just put this Wild Orchid in my upstairs dressing room bathroom. I call it a dressing room bathroom because, oops, that was my trash can lid. Because I'm going to be creating it, I'm in the process of redoing it and designing it into something that, of course, it's the upstairs bathroom, so if we wake up in the middle of the night, we can use the bathroom. We don't have to come downstairs. But it is a bathroom that is mainly going to be my bathroom for relaxing and putting on my makeup and just getting ready when I need to go somewhere. It's just, it's kind of girly and just really romantic. So that's the plan for that one. And this next lotion is the Crystal Water Spa Hand and Body Lotion, and I picked up the White Rose Blossom. It's a really gorgeous light green color, perfect for spring, with white roses, and the scent of it is just so, so fresh. I love it. It smells like rose, but it has, I don't know, a hint of something else, and I thought this would look so lovely on my dressing table in my bedroom, so I'm going to put that there. Also, beauty stuff. This is really cool. I found these, and I've never seen them up there before at the Dollar Tree. They're called Mineral Infusion Mineral Infusion. That must be the brand name. And they have, it says, with Dead Sea Minerals. Now, a while ago, my mom had given me something that had Dead Sea Minerals in it. And it was some sort of an eye serum and also a facial serum. So they had something very, very similar up there. So I bought the anti-wrinkle eye cream and the anti-wrinkle serum. So the serum is basically for your entire face. And it comes in this cute little box. But inside the box, who's not a sucker for packaging? I know I am. Anyways, inside the box is just a tube. And this is the, it's kind of hard to see. Again, I'm experimenting with lighting and direction and places in my house to film, so that's why these videos are kind of all over the place. The very first video I did in this series, I was sitting on the other side of the table, and the last two videos I'm sitting here because I have a light set up and it's facing me, and it's just, I think it was too much light in the first video. But anyways, this is the anti-wrinkle serum, and it goes all over your face, and I'm really excited about using that. And then of course the eye cream, same thing, comes in a little box, you open it up, and it is in a tube, and it's eye cream. So yes, very interested in trying those out. If they're anything like the products that my mom had purchased and given to me, they're going to be great. Okay, this isn't really a beauty product, but it kind of goes on the lines of Bath & Body. A while back, and I think I shared them in a video, I might have, anyways, I can't remember offhand right now, but I had purchased a pair of slippers, and they worked really well for a very long time, but they got kind of old and torn up, so, gosh, they were only a dollar, so I threw them away today because I found this pair. And the pair I had before was pink, and these are white, and these remind me of spa slippers. I just think that they're so pretty. They're kind of like a terry cloth, so I like those. I got them, and I also got some more light bulbs for all the little lamps that I have around my house, all the little mini lamps. And these are night light bulbs, and they are 7 watts. Also, beauty type products. I needed some isopropyl alcohol. Did I say that right? Isopropyl. Yeah. Isopropyl alcohol. Just to have around, you know, it's always good to have alcohol for cleaning things off and cleansing and stuff like that. And I have a recipe for a cleaner, sanitizer type of thing, type of product that I'm going to try. And a lot of people call it Florida water. I was just doing some research on it, and there's a lot of different recipes. But one of the recipes I saw was made with isopropyl alcohol instead of using drinking alcohol. The isopropyl alcohol makes it a little bit more affordable to create, and it's also something that would probably, well, alcohol kills all kinds of germs anyways, that kind of alcohol that you drink. But this alcohol kills a lot of germs as well. So I'm going to mix it up and put this recipe together and use it for probably a hand sanitizer too, because I'm always going out and buying hand sanitizers. So if this works, I might use it for my hand sanitizers as well, maybe put it in a small spritzer type of bottle. I don't know yet. We'll see. I'm just experimenting with different things right now. But certainly it's going to be something that will be good to just kind of cleanse surfaces off with. And I printed a really pretty label that I found on the internet of an Asian woman holding an umbrella. And I'm going to show you in the next video that I do a nice little bottle that I picked up today at the Goodwill store that I think might be perfect for my Florida water. We'll see. Getting back to the Dollar Tree haul. This particular year for the Easter holiday, I have decided that, and if my children are watching these videos, you already know what you're getting if you're watching this, but I have decided that I wanted to get them each a small little journal. And in the very first video that you watched in this series, I shared with you the beautiful vintage rose journal that I picked up at the Salvation Army store. So with that thought, I thought it would be really nice for my children to have a little journal to keep in their handbags too, or for my sons in their briefcases. So I picked up one for each of them, and I also got one for my son's girlfriend because they live together, and I wouldn't want to send him something without her, of course, so I think she'll really like it. And this is what I got for her. It's a beautiful little silver foil journal with a hydrangea, and I love hydrangeas. I have a whole story about hydrangeas that I could share with you, but that would get into way too much time, and I've already rambled too much, so maybe another time I'll tell my hydrangea story. If you're interested, leave me a comment below and let me know that you'd like to hear about my hydrangea story, and I'll share it with you. In the meantime, this is just all blank inside. And I think I'm going to write her a little message and include it with the journal to let her know how important and special hydrangeas are to me. And I wanted each of them to have a pen, too, to go with their journal. So I bought some pens, and I'm going to share that with you in just a moment. For my two daughters, Kelly and Nikki, and by the way, this one was for Kate, so I got that for her. For my daughters, Kelly and Nikki, I got them each this pretty little pink journal, and these were only a dollar. These ones are really nice, too. These are like a hardback book. They're just so sweet to keep in your handbag. So I got that for them, and for my boys, Grant and Justin, I got them each a black pocket journal. And just, I love them. They're just so, so elegant looking, I think. And for the boys, I picked up a couple pens. Now, I could get them each a set like they came, but I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to break this up because the men's or boys' look pens came in a set of two, and this is what they look like. And probably this video is like, the lens is probably so far away you can't even see these, but these are really nice, classy pens, and they're a dark brown with a grip that's black on the bottom, and they're a clip top pen. So I think the boys will really like it, and I'm going to include that with each one will get a pen with their journal. And then for my girls and also my son's girlfriend, Kate, I found this set of pens, and these are so pretty. They're floral, and they're the kind that have a cap that you take the cap off. And I like to write with these kind of pens. I think they're really elegant. And they actually match each one of these journals, so that's awesome. That is for them. And I do believe that that is everything in this Dollar Tree haul. Yes. So we've got one more video to go, and that is going to be from the Goodwill store. So stick around. I hope you enjoyed this video, as all of the other ones too, I hope. And thanks for watching. See you in the next video. Bye. Thank you.